The Slender Man, a being that was discovered at the Something Awful forums in a thread centered around photos from a singular fire which killed many children in the 80s. He is described as wearing a black suit and black hat, and as the name suggests, appears very thin and able to stretch his limbs and torso to inhuman lengths in order to induce fear and ensnare his prey. Whether he absorbs, kills, or merely takes his victims to an undisclosed location or dimension is also unknown, as there are never any bodies or evidence left behind. The Slender Man may have been around longer than many think. Some believe the Slender Man has been around for hundreds, possibly thousands of years. An archive of photos have been collected and gathered across the internet, ranging from recent to old family photos in the early 20th century. There is no specified region he is located at. He's been seen from the Midwest to as far as the New England states. Some believe he may be a manifestation from one's own mind, and only Slenderman can choose who sees him. From the archives of photos, it appears that Slenderman may have multiple forms, some impersonating a human, to others emulating more of a spider or tree shape. Stories indicate that victims who've ran from Slenderman can never escape. It seems there is a mental link with the subject, always allowing Slenderman to follow. Subjects who've been in contact with him have shown symptoms of paranoia, delusions, and complete personality changes. A common description of the Slender Man is his face, or lack of, instilling great fear in his subjects. The reasons for anyone coming in contact with him have yet to be concluded. What you are witnessing is raw footage from the Marble Hornets tapes about a filmmaker named Alex who is being followed by the Slender Man. His documentation was an important addition to the archives about the Slender Man, including over 26 entries that helped many people gain more understanding of this creature. Unfortunately, Alex is not the only person to come in contact with this being on record. On October 7th, 1989, police were conducting a search for a missing girl within Morgan County, Tennessee. A man by the name of Thomas Neely had been brought in for questioning while having it recorded for evidence. This tape has been classified for over 20 years, but has recently been released as a matter of public record. What you're about to hear may be disturbing.
Okay, we're recording now. Thomas, would you like to start from the beginning? Yes, Thomas, you're safe. Now, can you start from the beginning so that we may try to understand the events that happened?
Okay. My daughter, Jessica, she'd been outside playing at a friend's house, and we only lived up the street. They actually only lived up the street, I'm sorry. It started to get dark out, and I had called her friend's parents that she needed to get home. They told me that she left over a half hour ago. Well, they're only a 5-minute walk away, so I...
Is this where you left the house looking for?
Yes. We live in a wooded area, and I knew she liked playing there with friends, but going alone didn't make sense.
Okay, so what happened next?
I was calling Jessica's name, and it had been really getting dark out now. I was walking through the woods, looking and listening to anything. I remember suddenly feeling sick, like nauseous in the stomach, like I wanted to throw up. And I started getting ringing in my ears. Then I...
Thomas?
That... thing! That nightmare! Jessica's clothes. One of its hands.
It's okay. Can you please describe what he looked like?
It was tall. It appeared to be wearing a suit, but there's no way it was human. There's no way. The arms are almost to the ground. I've never seen anything like it. Its face.
It's okay, Thomas. You can continue.
That horrible fucking face! Just staring at me! But no, there was no face! There was no eyes! What did I see?
Thomas, please calm your...
No! No! I fucking saw you, son of a bitch! It took my Jessica! It's now coming for me! I can't sleep! I can't live! You don't know! You don't know! Oh God! Oh God!
Thomas,
it's
calm down!
Ah! It's right there!
You lose your pain, touch it!
Oh, holy shit!
There have been many sightings posted across the internet showing the different encounters with this being. As encounters get closer, it doesn't stop. Stories show that once the Slenderman gets close, it's not long before its victim finally disappears and is never seen again. So who is the Slender Man? A monster? An alien? An enemy? Ally? Or is he simply here as another species finding a way to survive? This documentary was created to bring awareness to these rising events, now able to be archived in the modern age. If you have any information leading to more details or whereabouts of the Slender Man, please let others know. As for me, well, Slender Man, I'm still running, and I won't allow you ever to find me.